वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू वन एंड ऑल. आई मीनाक्षी गुप्ता, डायरेक्टर ऑफ इंस्टीट्यूट फॉर ऑफिस मैनेजमेंट, न्यू दिल्ली YMCA, वेलकम यू ऑल टू द वेबिनार एम्पावरिंग लीडर्स ऑफ टुमारो, ऑर्गेनाइज बाय द न्यू दिल्ली YMCA इंस्टीट्यूट फॉर ऑफिस मैनेजमेंट.
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम.
I extend a very warm welcome to the Honorable GS and CEO of New Delhi YMCA, Mr. Mark S. Clive, who has been a pillar of strength for YMCAns. My word of welcome goes next to the Secretary Education, Mr. Vineet Masih. It is indeed a great pleasure to welcome our alumni of office management, Mr. Ashish Kumar, Ms. Manisha Obroy, Ms. Aarti Bajaj, and Ms. Kanchan Upadhyay. I welcome all the faculty members, my other colleagues, students, and all the participants on board. At the outset, may I request the GS and CEO of New Delhi YMCA to convey his greetings and to release the second edition of IOM newsletter, which was launched on September 1, 2020. So this is the second edition which sir is going to release. Over to sir, please.
Thank you, Mrs. Gupta, and a very good morning to all of you. On behalf of New Delhi YMCA, I welcome all of you to the webinar, especially the resource persons, the faculty members, and alumni and dear students. I must compliment the Institute of Office Management Leadership, especially the director and my colleague Vineet, for having thought of this webinar. And the theme is Empowering Leaders for Tomorrow. And this is what YMCA does throughout, and it had been doing it for last 7 decades, equipping young people in various skills, management skills, and other academic disciplines. So YMCA has played a very significant role in last 7 decades, and every year almost 2,000 young people join and go out of YMCA to the professional world. Well, I compliment the director, Mrs. Gupta, for this initiative and efforts, and we are planning to have these webinars almost every second week, or at least every second week, or maybe once a month. These are important programs, and I expect all the students to take advantage of it, because you're going to learn quite a lot from this, especially when we are going through this crisis that we can't meet face to face, but online is one facility which is helping us. So we must make best use of it. And the director and the faculty members, thank you very much for your efforts, for your initiatives. And it is my privilege to release this newsletter. It contains a lot of good information which will help you in your future endeavors, a lot of things to learn from out of it. So it's a beautiful document, and it is my privilege that I am releasing it. And carry on to repeat it again and again and again and again, because these are the documents which remain in our files, and we have we can go through them again and again. So thank you, Mrs. Gupta. Thank you, the resource persons. And thanks to all the participants who have come to join today's webinar. Thank you, and over to Mrs. Gupta.
Thank you, sir, for your praiseworthy and motivating words. And thank you for being with us, for sparing some valuable time, from your busy schedule.
Thank you. Thank you.
As you know that the Institute for Office Management was started way back in 1972 with an aim to develop the body, mind, and spirit of youth in order to make them learn, to be tolerant, supportive, and accepting all differences in abilities and beliefs. These values will take them beyond the narrow definitions of success and achievement. As the world moves towards unsafe and unsettled times, we will continue to provide to our students lessons in the courage and generosity of the human race and its ability to reconstruct and rebuild. The youth of today are the leaders of tomorrow. At YMCA, we equip them with the right set of skills and values to become the leaders, to become the best leaders of tomorrow. Testimony to it, we have with us the alumni of office management. They are the roots and branches of New Delhi YMCA, who build up on our brand value. They are indeed the brand ambassadors of YMCA. Students, I know you all are excited for today's event, to hear from your seniors, to know what's out there for you to achieve after completing diploma, advanced diploma, or postgraduate diploma in office management. Today, we have organized a special session for all of you, those who have already joined, those who are admission seekers, those who have registered with us, to get answers to all those queries bubbling up in your minds. We have with us our first speaker, Mr. Ashish Kumar, who will be sharing his experiences of YMCA journey with us. Mr. Ashish Kumar completed his diploma in office management in the year 2008-2009. He passed out in 2009. He did his graduation in BA pass from University of Delhi. He's a very hardworking, determined person and has a result-oriented approach. Before his diploma, he was with Global Consultant New Delhi from 2005 to 2009. Once he completed his diploma, he joined as Executive Secretary in Jagan Institute of New Delhi from June 2009 to June 2010. And afterwards, he joined ONGC Petro Editions Limited New Delhi as Executive Secretary from February 2010 to August 2011. At present, he is working as HR Executive in Adani Enterprises Limited, New Delhi, from September 2011 till date. His career objective is to be an asset for the organization by implementing his knowledge and skills while developing himself as a key resource of his organization. He has over 9 years of multidimensional and versatile experience in human resources, talent acquisition, operation induction program, training coordinations, recruitment of support services staff, event management, and administrative projects. Now I request Mr. Ashish to share his experiences with our, with all on board. Can you hear me, Mr. Ashish Kumar?
Maybe he's on mute and he's speaking, so probably he can check.
Okay.
He needs to unmute and then speak if that's the case.
Mr. Ashish Kumar, can you hear me? Mr. He's already with us. There must be some technical problem at his end. So can we show his PPT? Can we show his memories with YMCA? We need to enlarge it. Is Mr. Ashish Kumar, but I think it is not visible clearly as it is very small in size. May I request the co-host to enlarge it? Mr. Ashish Kumar, can you hear me?
Hello, can you hear me?
Yes.
Yes.
Please, you're welcome.
So, hi to everybody. So I was having, I think there were certain technical issues which was going on.
No issues.
So very good, good morning to all the panel members, jury, teachers, faculty, staff, and my young graduates. So it gives me a very warm moment that after so many years that your institute remembers you and that for an alumni meet. So I am very much glad for this. So I think you all must be charged, all the students must be very much charged and for the new world of Atmanirbhar Bharat. And I welcome you all for this session. So I'd be just briefing you about a small synopsis, precise about my candidature. So my name is Ashish and I've done my graduation from Delhi University from School of Open Learning 2007. And thereafter I was with YMCA doing a post-graduation diploma in office management in 2008 and 9 batch. Thereafter I was just, placed with JIMS, Jagan Institute of Management Studies, and there was a campus at YMCA. And I worked something about 7 months. And after that, I was got an opportunity with OPAL, that's ONGC Petro Editions Limited. And that's a JV of ONGC, GAIL and GSBC. I worked there nearly about, and I was placed at New Delhi in Tolstoy Mag only. So there, after working for 1.9 years, I got an opportunity with Adani as OPAL was shifting to Dahej, and I had my own ideas. I had my own dreams where I have to pursue my career. So I thought of quitting the job and finding a new job. And within a day and two, I got an opportunity and I got a call from Adani Group. And I went for the interview, and there was I was just called for a role for an executive secretary / EA, executive assistant to the GMHR. So the two members who were just taking up the interviews, the GMHR and the assistant manager, HR, and they were just explaining me about the rules and everything, right? So when they asked me about this PGDUM program, so I gave all the crisp answers to them and they were very much happy. but rather something was mentioned more onto my CV that was my previous experience of consultancy line of recruitments. Now they went into hardcore HR functions. Now I was pretty much astonished at why they are asking me about the core HR functions. So whatever things I was knowing about the core HR functions, I was just delivering their questions. After they went into more, they went into Maslow's, and I thought, ki, what is happening? I was pretty much confused inside me, but I was not able, but I was not showing my confusion and my uneasiness towards the questions, what was coming to me from the both ends. Rather, I gave, and there were two, three questions which I got and which I have read, but I was not aware. So I thought of rather in me that I should say no to that question. I thought round करने से वो होता है ना गोल गोल घुमाना तो वो गोल गोल घुमाने से अच्छा है कि बोल दो कि नहीं आता है ठीक है and they were very much impressed with this with my answers. The interview went nearly for 1 hour to 1 hour 25 minutes and after 5 to 10 minutes there was a negotiation started from the assistant manager HR and within 5 days I got an offer. And within 10 days, I joined Adani Enterprises Limited as a junior officer HR. And from 2011, I have been working with this organization. And now as I'm working as an executive HR and in talent acquisition, wherein I'm looking for the three of the BUs, that's mining, coal mining business, integrated coal management. Previously, it was known as coal trading and the Adani Bunkering Private Limited. That's a small synopsis about myself. Now, let's come on to the facts and the figures, what we are facing today. So, what we are looking today during past for the 6 months we are looking, that's COVID-19. Now, previously, everything was going very great in India and the GDP rate of India was something about 6.8%, right? But now, if you see the GDP rate of India, it has gone to a minus. And all these small SME sectors of India, and there is a job crunch of more than two crores of people have lost their jobs from the small SME sector, from the MSME sectors, right? But the big corporates, they are still playing and they are viable in the business and in the market. So Adani Group, Reliance, SR has now been lost. It has been taken by Nayara, and there are many more companies who are doing well and good because they are adding values to the India, because they are adding to the nation. Now, there are five factors which now we all have to work. First, I would like to tell you is the business sustainability first. Second would be your opportunity. Third would be your innovations. Fourth would be your own ideas, your own competencies. And fifth would be the ambiguity / conflict management. So these all five parameters, when you are exploring and when you're dealing in day-to-day life, you will really become a perfect person. And how to deal with the people, you must know the people management, what we are and how we are tackling every day. Rather, it be it any function, it be an HR. HR is divided into n number of functions. It is divided into first into recruitments and selection. It is divided into compensation and ben. It is divided into performance management. It is divided into IR issues. And there is one most important is a change management. So change management is very, very hard to accept, right? Suppose now you are working in any job role in today's life and scenarios. Now, after a month or so, and you have dealt with all that activities, what you are doing. Tomorrow, after 2 to 3 months, if I give you an opportunity and I tell you that I'm doing a role rotation, I'm doing a job rotation, I'm just moving you to a different department, and you're not aware of the function, that's called a change management. And it's very hard to accept. You'll show your agility that, no, I'll not be able to do that, but you have to take that. Because see, you cannot grow with one directions, right? You need to be a multitasking and you must know how broad you have to grow. See, going vertically is very easy, okay? You go for an officer, you go for executive, you go for an AM, okay? But making a horizontal base is much more important because your horizon should be broader rather than to your vertical lines. So these are the main mantras now we are just following up, right? if you talk about the business sustainability, right? What do we understand about the business sustainability? Business sustainability is what technology we are driving right now, right? Before we used to see that the IT companies in India, their male and female used to work from work from home, but we were all not working because we thought ki hum log ka kaam hi nahi chalega, right? But the IT companies of the small SMEs, the Indian MNCs, they developed a culture and they have made certain softwares and they have brought the technology inherent in their systems and processes that all the people who are working today, they are working from work from home. And it's very phenomenal to say that we are working with growth with goodness. We are adding a CTC to our life. We are working with more courage, commitment and trust. So that's the basic mantra. No one was not aware about this work from home. Now, but in the organizations, now we are working from 9:30 to 6:30. Moreover, 1 hour can be stretched to 7:30, right? And it depends upon the management call that how late you have to sit and something like that. That all depends on your work. But now when we are working from work from home, now people started something on 8:30, right? And they work till 9:30, 10 o'clock. So this is a business sustainability job. What things you are taking onto your life, what is the capability development you're making? Second, I'll tell you the opportunity. Opportunity always strikes at you, but it is you have to decide that you have to catch that opportunity or not, right? Innovations, I'll be telling you, innovation is much more nowadays in our system. We have brought n number of innovations in our country, and we are working on to that. Now, I'll be telling you, the fourth is the core competencies. You must understand your core competencies, what area you have to move, rather it be a science or a arts course, right? It doesn't matter. If you are just, if your interest area, if you are getting a marks of something about in your 10th or 12th, that you're getting something 96% in PCM or PCB, right? So you'll be thinking of going for an medical or for an engineering exams, right? But if you're not feeling to go in that area, don't go. I'll be very clear on that. Don't go on that area. Why people who are doing arts, they are not doing good in their life. They are doing much more good. People who are a BA or a graduate or a MA, they are doing MPhil, they are doing literatures, they are doing BA. People who they become IPS, IAS, DO, COs, n number of things. And last and the least, I'll be just concluding my point. That's ambiguity / conflict management. Ambiguity is basically what? Ambiguity is basically a haze, not clear. Kya karna hai? Mujhe nahi pata hai. Kisi ne kuch keh diya. Phir wo bhi wo clear nahi. Aise karna hai. But you have to know karna kya. You'll ask them, the person. You have to sit with the person. Kaise karein? What is the process? What is the chain we have to go with that? Theek hai? And if this conflict management is not resolved, then agility will come. And if this agility is coming in your life, it's very hard to deal with situations what we are facing today. Likewise, I'll give you a very small example that from 22nd March, I hope 22nd March, there was a lockdown in the country, which Narendra Modi has done, our Prime Minister. Now, there was a lot of agility. Now, he has done that. And now, so agility is there, but now who are managing? It is the people management who are doing all that. So people, we have to understand what we are doing and how we are doing. At least, last and least, there is a one formulation line who will design a framework in your life, and then you have to follow that pedigrees. So nothing more than that about myself and about these all philosophies and going more. We'll be doing all this in the questionnaire, what you'll be asking the practical questions and what we are dealing in the practical lives, right? So I'll be just transferring to the other alumni and rest the call to Meenakshi ma'am. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Mr. Ashish. Thank you so much for sharing your views and for dissecting the professional life so nicely, and giving tips to our, you know, present students and all the participants who are on the board.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
The next speaker for the day is Ms. Manisha Obroy, who was a topper of Diploma in Office Management course in the year 2005-06. Simultaneously, she did her graduation in BA Honours from University of Delhi. Her qualifications include simultaneously, I think she did, after completing her diploma, she joined another three diplomas simultaneously, that is Diploma in International Tourism of City and Guilds, London University from CUNY Academy of Travel, then International and Domestic Airfares and Ticketing from CUNY Academy, then Computer Reservation System from Galileo. She has worked with Internet as Customer Service Executive, then she, from September 2007 to June 2008. Later on, she joined as Business Development Executive in Prospector Software Private Limited from June 2008 to November 2008. Worked with Erio Management Private Limited afterwards from November 2008 to March 2011, where she joined as Executive Secretary to Director Development. And she was promoted to work with Head Hospitality since August 2010. She's currently working with Thales India Private Limited as Marketing and Strategy Analyst from January 2020 till date. She served for 9 years as the Executive Assistant to VP and Country Director from April 2011 to January 2020. Through her talent and hard work, she has gotten many golden opportunities to work with distinguished personalities like Mr. Ravish Kumar, Ms. Varkha Dutt, Mr. Rajiv Makhani. As a part of their production team, she's a versatile, self-motivated, and earnest personality. Over to her. She is going to share her experiences of YMCA.
Sure. Thank you so much, Dr. Manish. I mean, Akshay Gupta, for giving such a, you know, brief about my entire experience throughout. I would, you know, categorize my entire lines of 5 minutes in a category where my experience in YMCA, then a bit of my corporate life. And last but not the least, I would like to share experiences and some tips for the students how to excel with the capability that I could be, you know, I was able to excel myself and reach to this stage after 13 years of my work experience in the entire corporate industry. So from YMCA, I think it's the best way to start your career to have that knack of how to build yourself and how to plan yourself to be in the corporate world. You know, you have to, whether it starts from the typing, which is the most basic thing which is needed in whatever field you do. So that's, you know, one of the things. And how do you present yourself in the industry? How do you write in the industry? I'll share a small experience. You know, there was there's a word called convenience. I did not know the spelling of that so nicely. It was Nidhi Sharma, one of my, you know, teacher. She actually corrected me at least 10 times. And today I still remember her. Secondly, I would share some experience with Anamika ma'am. You know, she has been my mentor throughout. And this today also I am because of her. I was very bad at shorthand and she was a shorthand teacher for me. I would say shorthand is not used right now, but during those period, you know, the rapport that you build with the teachers here, the personal attention that YMCA gives to the students with whatever way you need, it's the best here. So I, you know, this is my experience with YMCA, and I would really appreciate all the teachers, faculty, principal, directors for, you know, being so supportive in this basic course, which people normally feel that it does not carry value. But I think this carries a lot of value, not only in terms of your professional, but personal career, personal growth as well. Then I would come to my professional experience. You have all explained my experience, but the main experience of mine is in Thales, which is 10 years, wherein precisely 9 years as an EA to the country director. So, and after 9 years of my work experience in EA profile is what I was able to change and excel myself into marketing, in the marketing profile. Now I would come back to how did I manage to do all this with some tips that I followed to, you know, excel myself. So firstly would be a pre-job, and second I would discuss the post-job. So before you start for going to a job interview, you need to, you know, have that keenness towards that job. We need to ensure that we have a mindset that, you know, we are going to get this job, rather than thinking that, you know, whether we will get or not. So if we have that positive attitude, which again comes from YMCA, they always give you that positive attitude to keep in your mind while you are in your interview. Secondly, how you will make a difference to the organization you're going to. It is very important that you need to sell yourself that how interested you are and what value add you will bring to the industry when you would be there. Coming to post-job. So once you have got the job, you have to ensure that you become indispensable. Like everybody should just look for you, whether it's your manager, whether it's your team, whether it's the people around you. You have to build that confidence in the team. You have to build that confidence in the people that they look for your work and you do the work with perfection. And you have to make people dependable. People say that you should not be indispensable, but as per my experience, I think unless you are indispensable, you cannot grow. Now, with this, I would say that, you know, we all are into difficult times, especially with COVID-19. So what is that we can do with, you know, this EA profile? Everybody says that, you know, you cannot do anything without being home. You have to be at work. But I do not agree to that. I think you can do very well while being at home. How? Firstly, you need to be taking initiative in other fields also. You have to see which is the area of interest. Side along the being at EA, there is one field that you can pick it. You can start showing your interest towards other things, which may also add value to your current profile. For example, myself, I liked to be into event management as well. So side along my EA profile, I started picking up certain coordination work of events, and which built the confidence in my, you know, manager. And that's where I could also handle events. Coming to, you should always have a pen and diary with yourself wherever you go. Of course, we are in the digital world. I understand all of us must be thinking that it's not really what makes a difference, but I will tell you, always a pen and diary makes a lot of difference, because you, so what you pen down goes inside you. What you type may not always be consistent in your mind. You always should dress yourself well for any virtual meeting that you're doing and whenever you're going to workplace. Even if your mood is not good, you know, when you dress yourself well, that confidence level, that the way you give your persona to others, the positive vibes, that changes. And now I would say that, you know, I could brief my entire speech in 4 P's. First will be perfection. In whatever work you do, you should be perfect or close to perfection, if not perfect. Second P would be, you should be proactive, especially in the profile of executive assistant. Unless you're proactive, you know, you should do things much before your manager is even asking you to do. And this is one of the keys of my success, I would say. Coming to the third P, which is being participative. In whatever way you could participate to the organization, could be, you know, at times we get emailers from communications team for events, etc. We don't even consider them, but honestly, being participative in the organization definitely helps you build yourself as a better team person. And the fourth P would be being planned. This planning is what will definitely help you a lot. And this is something which is needed in everything in your life. And for myself, my career, I would definitely say I've always been planned. And even before a day when I have to go to the work next day, I plan everything one day before. So I really thank YMCA to give me this opportunity. And I hope my talk was very crisp, but I wanted to conclude in a manner that, you know, people are getting tips from me rather than I sharing something which may not be relevant to them. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, Manisha. Thank you so much. for sharing eloquently, you know, your experiences of YMCA with us and with students, and for sharing your professional experiences so nicely. You have, I mean, I must compliment you for remembering all those, you know, small things which you experienced at YMCA. Absolutely. And remembering all your faculty members.
No, definitely. And till date, I'll tell you, I'm still connected with Anamika ma'am as a mentor to me. I have some connection throughout, that she's always been a guiding force for me. You know, every step I was changing my role, I called her if it's a good idea or not. So, you know, and this is the legacy of YMCA.
Yeah, we always feel that once a student is with YMCA, is or she is a part of Y family.
Absolutely.
So you are always a part of us.
Thank you so much for giving that opportunity, ma'am.
So moving on to our next speaker, Ms. Aarti Bajaj. She completed Diploma in Office Management course in the year 2006-07. She has always been a diligent, dedicated, quick learner and persevering individual. She did her graduation in BCom Pass from University of Delhi. She has worked with Belimo Accutators, if I'm pronouncing it correctly, Mumbai, as office coordinator from February 2007 to 2008, March. She worked with NDTV Limited, New Delhi, as Senior Transmission Controller, Broadcast Operation and Engineering Division from March 2008 to September 2019. She is currently working with Satin Credit Care Limited, Gurgaon, as PR Manager, starting from September 2019 till date. A career objective is to work in a challenging and stimulating environment, contributing towards the achievement of organizational objective with her professional skills and also gaining more knowledge and experience. Over to her.
Good morning, ma'am. Good morning, all the faculty members. And I would like to say that Mr. Ashish and Ms. Manisha have spoken very well. I don't know, maybe I won't be able to speak that well, but yes, I would sure like to share my experience, my personal, how YMCA groomed me and how this corporate world groomed me. I would sure like to share my experience. First of all, I would like to say a big thank you to Ms. Anamika ma'am for giving me this opportunity to speak here. I'm so glad I got the opportunity here. So I started with YMCA in 2006 and 2007 batch. After doing my YMCA diploma in management course, I got an opportunity to work with Belimo Actuators Mumbai as a secretary to my CEO. So I worked there for 1 year. So I must mention here that I got this opportunity to work in Belimo Actuators as a secretary to my CEO just because of this course. Because when I joined this course, I should be true to myself, I think. I would like to say that I was nothing before I joined YMCA. This is just because of this course only that I am here, what I am doing right now. So, I would like to share one of my experiences from YMCA. I remember the first day of my orientation in YMCA, how it helped me. It was my first day in YMCA and the orientation given, I think, by the principal. So what he told this, that how this course would gonna help me, how this course would gonna teach me. And I felt so good that time when I attended that orientation. That orientation gives me a feeling of confidence. I was at zero when I joined YMCA, but now where I am is because of this course only. Because when I joined that orientation, I was so happy. When I came back home, my father, my mother asked me, why are you so happy? This is just a YMCA course. This is not St. Stephen's or Gargi. But I said, for me, this is the Gargi College. This is the St. Stephen's for me, because I had never been to any college. When I joined this course, I was in my second year of BCom, I remember. So for me, this was everything. I knew that I had to do this course. This course will groom me. I knew. So I joined and I learned a lot from this course, a lot. And I'm not saying this because I have been invited here to speak. No, this course has actually groomed me. I would love to talk about YMCA every time. In every interview, I have praised a lot. Okay, so further to that, I worked in Mumbai in Ballymore Actuators as a personal secretary to my CEO. So I remember joining there. It was my first job as a personal secretary. I didn't know anything. But yeah, I remember what my teachers told me, how to be a good, how to sit at a good posture, how to use the cutlery when I was with my seniors at the lunch table. So I remember each and everything from here. Okay. Then after doing my job for 1 year, I changed my line completely. I shifted from personal secretary to I went into a technical line in NDTV. I joined NDTV Limited, the news channel, in 2008. So I worked there. I served NDTV for 12 years. I worked there from February 2008 till September 2019. I was in NDTV. I got to work there with Mr. Ravish Kumar, Ms. Barkha Dutt. I worked under their influence and I worked very hard and really hard to become a part of their team. So I'm just want to say, I'm not a speaker, I'm not a guide, I don't want to be a mentor. I am just what I am with the teachings of YMCA. So being a student of YMCA, I'm saying that I feel really proud that where I am. I remember I was with Ravish Kumar in a rally. I think it was April 2019 when Kanhaiya Kumar filed his nomination for Begusarai elections. So I was walking with Ravish Kumar in that rally, and from there to sitting here and from YMCA till here, it's been a great journey for me. And I love being here, and I love being into a corporate world. So I just want to share that what you need to be in a corporate world, I mean, what lessons I have learned to survive in the corporate world. The first of all is, I would like to share, this is my personal experience. I don't know about what others you feel about this corporate world. That first of all, I would like to say that your worth to the company and its people is tied to your last performance. I must mention this. I don't know. If you are a performer for 5 years in a row, or whatever reason you did not manage to get a top rating of this year, you are doomed. And to play the rating game is like being in a war zone. It's a bloodbath out there. I think all companies are not the same, but you may think that in your amazing company that really sit down and evaluate all your results, compare them to your peers, iron out to the differences in your work plan and workload, and give you a fair assessment to where you stand. If you go to work thinking that at the end of the year, this is how evaluation will be done, you're in a huge for a setback. And second is, people are nice to you only when you are influential or they need you. Once the need or the influence changes, so does their behavior. I have noticed this thing a lot in my career. So, and third, I would like to say promotions. Your promotions are not linked to your performance, I think. At best, they are linked to the perception of your performance. And one more I would like to share, that taking the right opportunity at the right time is more important than results, I think. So, and one is, when you are the star, more mistakes are forgiven. I mean, when you're the star for your company, most mistakes are forgiven to you. So be an asset for your company. I would like to say, be an asset for your company. Be a good performer. Learn new thing every day. And I think the top skills you need to be in a corporate world these days is, you should have the leadership qualities. You must be a leader to get what you desire. You must be a leader. and learn something new every day, and the time management is a mundane phenomenon that is a fading away gradually, as obviously the work required work from home, as Miss Manisha said. So as professional, most of you tend to spend close to 10 hours at work, and within that limited time you are expected to manage your work and various other tasks, so that are not directly related to your job. So in such time, in such crunching schedule, it is crucial that you prioritize multiple activities effectively. And the second is, I think you should be flexible about your working hours. When I was in NDTV, and now I have changed my profile, but when I was in NDTV, I have worked there with flexible timings. I mean, I think when you start your career, you should be flexible with your timings. I think if they're asking, I was in media, so they were expected to come when there is some breaking. So they expected me to come at night. When there is some emergency, so they expected me to stay till late. I remember when 26/11 happened in Mumbai. So I worked in NDTV for like continuously for 48 hours also. So you should be flexible if you want your promotions, if you want the growth. So in starting, I think you should be flexible about your working hours. Obviously, you should be safe too. Nowadays, the crime level is too high, so you should be safe too. But yeah, I would like to say that flexible timings are very important. And what more should I say? Now I'm working with the Saturn credit limit. I would like to share one more thing, that starting from personal secretary, then being into this technical line, then again after 12 years I changed my line, and now I'm into PR. I promote my brand Saturn Credit Care. So I think it doesn't matter what you have done, what course you have done. I think the experience counts. So like when I start with doing that secretary job, so I groomed myself there. I remember I worked very hard. I spent extra hours at work and not getting any remuneration for that, because I wanted to gain experience, because I know that I want to go ahead of this also. So I went ahead, not just 9-to-5 job. I gave my extra hours to my work. So like I participated in many activities rather than work, just to be counted in my seniors' eyes. Mujhe tha ki I want to shine in their eyes so that I will get promotion, I'll get opportunities to work with higher people. So when I got experience there, I shifted from media. So now I am here. After getting 12 years of experience in media, I came here because I knew that jumps, I think, are very important. You should not stuck to a job for a longer. Obviously, I have done 12 years. I have spent 12 years in media industry. But after some time, I thought, now this is the time I should come out of my comfort zone. I think getting out of your comfort zone is very important, students. Like, agar aapko lage ki, okay, you have the passion to do a job, for example. You are doing 9-to-5 job, sitting comfortably in an AC room. Okay, you do your job and coming back, it's easy. But what after that? What about your passion? I think you should have that passion. And for that passion, you have to come out of your comfort zone. I came out of my comfort zone from NDTV, and now I'm here sitting with higher level people in PR agency. I'm promoting my brand. I attend meetings in Mumbai, sometimes in Vadodara. I mean, many places. So this opportunity I got only when I came after my comfort zone. But there was nobody to guide me. So mujhe ye late samajh mein aaya. But now when so many people are here, you are getting so much opportunities. These online classes, these teachers, your mentors, they are telling you so much. So I think you are in the right hands. this YMCA faculty, I'm not praising, I'm not praising them ki I'm being invited here, so I'm praising them. No, I think this is the time you should understand that teachers are, I mean, you're everything. They groomed you well. Whatever they taught you, you will be needing that somewhere in life, even the small things. I remember once I was at my lunch table with some senior officials. I remember one incident. I forgot ki, okay, to which hand I should pick that cutlery and that fork and that spoon. That was, I think, business communication class by Nidhi Malhotra ma'am. So that clicked in my mind. Okay, she told me that this should be in this hand and this should be in this hand. So every little thing they taught you here, you will be needing that somewhere in life. So, I mean, all the experience, I have done nothing, to be honest. I just have done my graduation and this course from YMCA. And today where I am, I think I'm content. I am happy and I'm content. The package I'm getting, the place where I am, with the people surrounded by I am content. I'm very happy. And I think I should gratitude it for every day. And last but not the least, yes, you should be a good presenter. In interviews, in your class, everywhere, I think that speaks a lot than your studies. If you are a good presenter, if you have a good communication skills, if you can speak well, if you can stand in the crowd, I think nothing can stop you. This is the only thing I want to say. Nothing can stop you from doing anything, be it you are going to a media industry, you are going to secretarial world, you are going to corporate world, you are going anywhere. If you can stand out in a crowd, you're good to go anywhere. Thank you so much for inviting me here. And I think I have spoken well. I don't know. If you want to ask me something, I'm always here to answer you. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Aarti. We feel honored and privileged to hear all that from you, your learnings from YMCA, the way you have explained. I mean, it was nicely expressed to all the students. In fact, the learning tips given by you to students that one should be, in the learning mode all the time, that is very important. Rightly said by you, one should not be time oriented, that these are the fixed time intervals. One should be task oriented. Yes, task is more important as compared to your time schedules.
Yes.
So one should be focused towards the task. And definitely success is yours if you are working with full heart. Wholeheartedly working will definitely take you to the success. Moving on to our next speaker, Ms. Kanchan Upadhyay. She completed diploma in office management course in the year 2015-16. An ambitious, task-oriented person, she was the class representative at YMCA who efficiently carried out the responsibilities assigned to her. She completed her bachelor's in English honors from University of Delhi and is pursuing her master's in English honors from IGNU. She has worked with meetcareer.com as a content writer from August 2016 to May 2018. Currently, she is working with Viva Holidays Private Limited as a subject matter expert from July 2018 till date. Her career objective is to work effectively, sincerely with diverse groups of people. She is persistent, flexible, and committed to excellence always. Over to her, over to Kanchan.
Hello, everyone. Hope everyone is doing good and keeping safe during this pandemic. I am Kanchan Upadhyay from the batch 2015-16 of the course Diploma in Office Management. First, I would like to thank my class teacher, Seema ma'am, and director ma'am for giving me this opportunity to share this online platform with everyone and share my experience. Thank you so much. I am immensely satisfied with my teachings at YMCA and consider it to be a blessing of to be a student of this institution. Actually, teachers here focus on making you more self-disciplined, obedient, organized, and versatile. Here, you'll realize that out of your personal growth, you are grown professionally as well. After completing my course, I was offered good placement options. I chose to be a writer and I worked as a writer for two years with an online education job portal, which is meetcareer.com. And after that, I started working with a London-based travel firm, which is Viva Holidays Private Limited. It's been 2 years I'm working here and I'm currently working here as well. So apart from your key responsible areas, right, apart from being a writer or being a subject matter expert, sometimes your job demands more than this. Like apart from this, I'm asked to be an HR sometimes, maybe a PR, or you know, if there are events handling the events. So while I remember that, I was a class representative. Thank you so much, Seema ma'am, my class teacher, for giving me this opportunity during that time. I remember during the course studies, there were other key responsibilities as well. So yeah, remembering that, prioritizing all that work and keeping your cool. This is what you are taught over your course duration, be it for a year or two. This is what you are taught. And you know, when you all will complete your courses, go out and work, you will realize that whatever you have been taught over here has come into practice. So after completion of my course, in whichever field you'll go, your teachings that you have been taught over here will make you come out with flying colors. During my course, I, thought that I'll be only working as a secretary or a personal assistant or something related to office, but that wasn't the case at all. I was able to choose my job profile, whichever, I wanted, and in whichever field I was comfortable, I was able to choose that, and all my teachings has fallen into place. The other alumni that I've spoken, they are all way before passed out. I think I'm the most recent passed out of them all. So I would really like to share the course content that I've studied so that the students will get idea of what they are going to study further. So starting the first subject I had was business English communication, in which we were taught of the basic written communication, including emails, emailers, then letters, memorandums, and everything I use each day in my office, basically emails. Emails are, of course, in whichever office you work, you're going to use it. So yeah, business English communication, very much important. Second one was functional English, in which there was English grammar, basic and enhanced English grammar, taught by Anamika ma'am, and Anamika ma'am taught it very beautifully. She taught that English is a very flexible language and you can mold it the way you want. And this is what I have experienced. Thank you so much, ma'am, for your teachings. Then the subject was computers, in which basic computers is taught to you. So whichever, Microsoft Office, Internet Surfing, HTML, whichever you use in your day-to-day life, that is all taught to you. The other one was shorthand, my favorite subject. It's been 4 years I have completed YMCA, but still I like writing shorthand. When I did my first job with Meet Career, my director was very happy to know that I know shorthand, because there were board meetings and everything. So writing in English and writing in shorthand, they are two very different things. So yeah, then we started going to the board of director meetings, noting down minutes of the meetings. So he was very happy to know about that. Moreover, my sister, she is doing the same course. I suggested her of YMCA, but it's just that she wanted to do a degree in the same. So she is doing a 3 years degree in the same course from Delhi University. But she likes studying shorthand from me more than her teachers. All thanks to Seema ma'am for making it very much easy. Seema ma'am also taught office management, in which you are taught of work ethics, work environment, office automation, not just the theory but the practical as well. You are taken over to see the office machineries, how they work and everything. I mean, here what I learned is that studies are never only theory, they are practical as well. Then we had typing, that's basic typing we are taught. Then we had one class of communication lab. In communication lab, that's the most practical class. And here you will learn about oral communication, you know, the way you have to carry yourself, you have to go for the interviews, and then you have to, we had role plays, we had interview sessions. So the teacher during that time, you know, noticed every small little thing. And then she used to tell, okay, you have to do this, improve this, you have to speak this much. So very qualitative and quantitative analysis of communication was done in that class. So, and I really don't think that any subject of it has gone into vain. Each subject is of equal importance, and I am still using every one of it. Actually, I miss YMCA more than my school, especially the cultural fest time. I am very extra co-curricular person. Apart from studies, I really like singing, dancing, writing, all this. So yeah, the fest time is my most memorable time in YMCA. Very professionally handled, and along with your studies, not even a single class was missed. After your classes, you were allowed to do the practices, and the first day was the most fun day. So yeah, it's not just a theory that you come and learn, but there are so other broad horizon here that you can experience. Seema ma'am, my class teacher, I'm in constant touch with her. It's been 4 years. She has been an amazing guide and mentor. She's there for support all the time. Also, I would like to take a moment and thank all the staff, management, teachers, director at YMCA. Thank you so much. And thank you so much for having me here today. Thank you.
Thank you, Kanchan. Thank you for explaining the course content so nicely and for sharing your memories of YMCA with all of us. In fact, I still remember you dancing. Yesterday, I was seeing your, pics. We were trying to show you a few of your memories. So we were looking for you, in many of the pics. So I found you dancing in one of the pics, and we are going to share it right now.
Thank you.
I still remember you, the way you used to take part in extracurricular activities and all. May I request the co-host to showcase us her talent and her memories of YMCA? Although these are very small in size, can we make it a little bit enlarged? So it is difficult to understand where are you in these. We'll try next time, or we'll show it in alumni meet, in an alumni interaction session. She's there. So we'll be definitely showing them later. Technical problem, we are unable to enlarge it, so students won't be able to see it clearly. So this is an Umang Fest. About what she's talking about. She took part in dance competition. She's there with her ma'am's faculty.
Hello.
We can't hear anything.
Ma'am, I think you have muted your audio. We are not able to hear you.
I'm so sorry. There was a power cut and then there was an internet problem at my end. So am I audible now?
No, that affected us also. Again, we have re-login.
Okay. So is it now, you can hear me and we all are connected now?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, definitely. I can see all the participants who are connected now.
Right. So, moving on, so I was discussing about Kanchan only, and we could see her performances in YMCA, and later on we'll be sharing it with our students. So one thing I would like to say, as Aarti mentioned, that she still remembers her orientation program. I would like to say recently only, we have conducted orientation program for our new joinees, and I hope and I'm sure that they will be remembering in the same manner the way Aarti is remembering it till date. So moving on to few, now house is open for question answers from our panelists. So may I request, anybody is having any question can write in the chat box, or you can raise your hand and ask the question. So may I request all the participants, all the panelists, to be ready to answer the questions.
Good morning to all present.
Good morning.
Good morning.
My name is Sonal. I am pursuing advanced diploma in office management. So, what are the challenges that you have faced in your career?
So, I would like to mention one thing in between before any panelist starts answering, that we have started with our 2-year program also. Since you all joined a way back, 15 years back or something like that, now we have 2-year program in diploma, this office management, that is called as advanced diploma in office management. So she's a student of advanced diploma in office management who is asking questions. Sonal. So may I request the panelists to take up?
Definitely. Hi, Sonal. This is Manisha. So basically, you would like to know the challenges. I would say in this particular profile, the only challenge is to how to change the role. For example, once you have attained, confidence in this field and you have, excelled in this profile, you feel that, you are getting monotonous. The thing is, that you want to change. So one major challenge is that how you can change your profile. And second challenge that you normally face is, how to manage your work, because the workload at times is so much, and, being at the top level bosses, they demand everything in hurried manner. So how you can tackle that situation, how you do politely say no, and how you prioritize your work. These are the major challenges from my side, from my experience.
Okay.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Good Any morning. Other question?
Yes, ma'am. Good morning, respected General Secretary, sir, and Director, ma'am. And to our dear alumni, my name is Jyoti, and I'm in January batch. We would like to know about your experience as a student of YMC.
Aarti, you need to unmute, I think.
Okay, oh, sorry. I am unmute. Can you hear me?
Yes.
I hope there is a certain disruption.
Yeah, there is a network problem, Aarti, at your end.
Yeah.
Okay. Being here. One second.
I think bandwidth problem is there at Aarti's end.
So if you could switch off your video, maybe the bandwidth will be slightly better.
Yes, it would be better.
It's better now?
Yes, it's better.
Okay. Can I answer now?
Yes, Aarti, please.
Okay. So Jyoti, you wanted to know our experience in YMCA, I think. That was your question, no?
Yes, ma'am.
I think all of us, we have some good experiences here, fun loving. I mean, when I joined NETV, so I was in Faridabad. So from Faridabad to coming to Delhi is all the way a new experience for me. And it was my first college. YMCA was my first college. I was never been in any college before YMCA. So there are many small, small fun loving experiences, one of which I would really like to tell you, that was my first day of YMCA. Okay. And I think there was no metro that time, no metro connectivity to Faridabad, from Delhi to Faridabad. So I used to travel by a local train. So that I was so stupid. I should not say, but I was so stupid that time. That was my first day at YMCA. I took a wrong train from Delhi to Faridabad. Instead of taking Delhi to Faridabad, I took a wrong route from Delhi to Ghaziabad. I remember that was my first day. And then when I reached Ghaziabad station, I was like, oh shit, where I am? There was nobody at the Ghaziabad station. So I think this is the most one of the fondest memory I have of entering into my first day of YMCA, and I got fooled. I think over to you, other faculties.
I would like to add a certain part to that. See, my memories in YMCA has been something different. See, as though I was working and simultaneously I was just taking my classes. So I used to rush to my classes something about 9:30, and I used to take my classes by 1:30 or 2. And the last class was Mr. Bhatia, sir, certain classes. So I used to take my, as soon as the classes was over, so I used to rush outside. And used to take a bus, and then I used to go to Lakshmi Nagar to do my this official works, right? And there I used to spend something about 8:30 to 9:30 I was working, right? So this was my routine life. But there's a big but in the in between. Memories in YMC has been a part of the, like, Sneha ma'am, Radha ma'am, Bhatia sir. See, so Bhatia sir was into shortened classes, and while Sneha ma'am and Radha ma'am was helping all the students. That was, I hope, at that time it was 44, the females were there, and we were 8 boys who were working. But in the classes, n number of times we are doing the extempos, we are doing the GDs, that's group discussion, PDs, personality developments, right? Variety types of rules we are playing, how we there's a manager, there's a secretary, there is an other rules characters we are playing. So these are the memories which we have incorporated in ourselves. It is very necessary to understand that what core competences you are having inherent in you. Take care. No, only the mentors can teach you, the faculty members can teach you, they can show you the way, right? But your competencies, you have to develop, your personality, you have to develop. I'll tell you, be very frank. See, if you're having only, if you're having only 2 pair of clothes, right? And you cannot buy that and more clothes, right? So that clothes needs to be pressed every day, right? It can be one alternative you can wear, but you cannot wear a hazy or you cannot wear a shabby clothes and come to your office. Rather, it should be pressed. It should be nicely washed. So these are the small, small etiquette which you need to develop in your life also. And thus, this will enhance your career, your opportunity, your sustainability in the markets, right? So that's all my experience. And thank you to Sneha ma'am and Radha ma'am and Bhatia sir for experiencing me all this small, small, minute thing. And I was working for prima facie. I was working for 2 years, 2.5 years into the secretarial role. Thereafter, I moved into the operations, HR operations. Then I moved into talent acquisition role. And thank you and hats off to all the faculty members, directors for this. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Good morning, everyone.
Yeah.
I am Vaishali from January Batch 2020. And we are curious as to how was your experience in interview? What do you think the companies are looking for in a candidate?
See, I would rather ask other panel members to answer this question because I have been interviewing a number of candidates and a number of times. So rather they would be explaining much more.
See, when you're talking about, you know, what they're looking forward in a candidate, I would say that, you know, how planned you are in this kind of a role, what difference can you make? As I rightly also mentioned this in my speech during the time that I was making, that you have to prove yourself right, that how differently can you work, how proactive you are, and what approach you are taking towards the time management of your entire activities. I'll be short and crisp.
Yes. And one thing I want to say, that one challenge that I faced in my interviews, that it was hard for me to convince my interviewer that how I'm fit for this role. This is the last interview when I had in this company where I'm currently working. So this is the only challenge I faced. I had to convince my interviewer that how I am fit for this role. So but finally I convinced him and I got the job. So this is the only thing which I faced in my interview. Challenge, you can say.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you so much.
I hope Shalini, right? Hello?
Sir, Vaishali.
Vaishali, I would like to tell you certain of the pointers which you need to focus on to your day-to-day life while you are entering into the corporate world, right? Okay. So first, when you're going for interviews, first of all, be on a time, right? See, yes, there can be many instances. There can be many instances when you're going for an interview. So the interview panel may not be free at that point of time because they have given you a specific time, but they won't be available due to their work exigencies. They might be working on that on their priorities rather than they'll be looking. You'd be getting bored. Kya company hai, kaisi company, ghatia company, blah, blah, blah. Many things would be coming onto your mind. But it is your cohesiveness, because please understand there is a monitoring system which is going in the company and which is watching you every time that what you're doing at the leisure time. Okay. How you're moving your hands, how you're moving your feet, how you're things. So these are the basic hygiene factor which you need to understand first. Now, second, and suppose and you're coming to the cabin and you're attending the interviews. Now, first of all, there are 2 to 3 parameters which needs to be understood. First is what is your confidence level? What is your presentation? What's your style of presenting to the others? Take care. Don't make any if you're not knowing any question, don't make any round clocks like Gol Gumana, and please be very specific, crisp to the questions, right? How you sit is very much, be very flexible in your sitting, right? You don't need to sit like straight postures, you are like that, right? Be very specific in sitting. One thing, keep a smile onto your face. You don't need to be very strict that I'll not. If I'll smile there, then my candidate will be rejected. So these are small parameters which works very good. Your confidence level should be, your eye catching with the manager and with the panelist must be there, right? And this only shows your confidence level. So these are the small mantras which you need to carry into your corporate world while you're entering. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you so much, sir. Very
and adding to this, I would like to add one more point in this, that I think you should do your homework in advance. In which company you are going, just read their profile thoroughly, what they are into, what they are doing, what they are, where they are going, what they want, what they are looking for. I think you should do your homework in advance. Read about that company where you are going to interview yourself. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Good afternoon to everyone. My name is Vandana. I have actually two questions. Am I audible to everyone?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. I actually have two questions. One is related to profession and one is a little personal. So I really hope any one of you can answer that. My first question is, I have worked for 10 years as a PA in different companies. I was into event management as well. As a promoter, I used to work in events. And after that, I used to do regular jobs. But I was working with the very small companies, you know, which we call Lala type companies. So that kind of companies. So I did not get so much knowledge from there, and I don't know where I am today because it's been 10 years. So I should be somewhere just like you guys, but I'm not. So I am asking you this course. I have just joined in September. It is just few days. I have joined this course, PG Diploma in Office Management. I just wanted to ask that how this course going to add strength to my career. What kind of strength I will get from this course? And my second question is, I'm like a phobic of interview and exam and test, whatever you can say. Whenever it comes, whenever I hear this word that this is going to be, I'm going to be interviewed by someone or I'm going to get tested, I just get, you know, panic attacks. So because of this, I am not able to change my job. I always used to think that I should be in the job where I am doing right now. So I just want if someone can answer this.
See, I'll be very specific. So you have worked for 10 years as a you have worked as an PA, you have worked as an event manager with some small SME sectors, right?
Yes. Yes.
Vandana. So tell me, out of the 10 years of experience, how many companies have changed up?
If I'll say regular, I'll change two companies. I was Hello? There for am I audible?
Yeah. How many
If I'll say regular companies, there was two companies. I worked 6 years in a same company and then for 1.5 years in another company. Apart from these years, I was into 4 years management, like event management. As a promoter, I used to work.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Now, when you're working for 4 years as a into this PR agencies?
Through coordinators, I used to get events. Exhibitions.
You were an event manager, right?
No. I was as a promoter. I was working.
You're working as a promoter.
Promoter.
So what was the size of that company?
It was a freelancing, I guess. It's not a freelancing. Company.
Freelancing. And so you used to then get vendors and you used to host that
program,
right?
Yes, I used
program,
to get
right?
approached by the event management companies and I used to work like 5 days, 6 days for events and then I used to go to the another company and this kind of work. You know, exhibition in Pragati Maidan happens. So that kind of
See, I'll tell you, first of all, I'll be very specific onto these questions, right? So you are as an event manager and right now you're doing your postgraduate diploma in office management first.
Yes, this I have worked as PA as well in my previous company.
PA as well. So I'll tell you, Vandana, right? Vandana, see, there is an N number of opportunities in the market which is coming for an EA role. See, I have done my PG Diploma in 2008-09 batch. And right now, for the past 9 years, I'm into HR field, right? But there are certain parts which are mentioned in my CV as an EA role and or slash as an executive secretary role. But still, I'm getting very good opportunities for the markets, right? And the pay package is something about 25 to 30 plus, right? Now, this program, postgraduate diploma in office management, will definitely help you in getting your career success, right? and you need to be very much presentable onto that. I'll be coming again to this question. Now you are very much phobic. You are very much phobic for the interviews and for the exams. You get panic attacks, like the skills and presentations need to be. So there's a one thing you can do onto that, right? I'll tell you, many of the persons who are very
I'm
much.
I'm sorry to interrupt you, Ashish. I'll have to leave. Thank you so much, everyone. I have another meeting to head towards. Thanks, not everyone. Anything. I'll take a leave. Thanks, everyone.
Thank you so much, Manisha.
Thanks so much, ma'am.
For sparing valuable time. I know you all are working. I mean, you are tuning in from this itself.
Sure. I'm sorry once again to interrupt during this webinar.
No.
Thanks.
Thank you for your time.
Not at all. Thank you so much, everyone.
Thank you.
Please carry on.
Now, I'll be telling you, as though you told that you are phobic for the interviews, you are getting panic attacks and you are not so presentable and your skills are getting something distempered. Go to the mirror, okay? Please be
even exams, and test also.
See, I'll tell you now, you have worked as an event manager, you have worked as a freelancer, then why you are having this phobia? The question arises. See,
It is from childhood.
Okay.
Childhood. So this phobia
can be reduced. It cannot be removed. This can be reduced to some extent, right? So you have to practice for all these things in front of a mirror only, right? Bang. When you are making a mistake, think that your mirror is your manager, right? And if you are making certain mistake, now bang onto your cheeks. Things will improve. First, now you read English newspaper?
Yes, I do.
How do you read? How do you read?
A simple, the way we read anything, article.
Do you pronounce? Do you talk with the newspaper?
I speak loudly. When I read it, I speak loudly.
No. Do you speak with the newspaper? Many of the people in India, and every home we are having a newspaper in the early in the morning, and the news vendors give their papers. Now, when we are reading the newspaper, please try to understand. And this phobia I was also having, and I recognized it. Right. So when I'm reading a newspaper in my mind that my name is so. Now, when you start pronouncing that words one by one, you will try to understand how much error you are making. Please make a habit of reading the newspaper 1 hour loudly. Then you will understand. And I guarantee this, that within a month, your way of communication, your way of skills of presentations will much, much get improved. Now, your second question was your fabric of examinations. Why you are fabric of examinations? Why the GD and PD interventions you are not taking in the classes which are continuously going within YMCA? Are you not taking part?
I have just joined like few days
ago. Now your mentors. Who are your mentors? Now there are n number of faculty members who are there and who would be designing you, who would be formulating you on your day to day life, right? You'll be coming into n number of extempore. Please come on to extempores as though you are joined in January this year only, right? Come on to extempore. Come for the GD and the PD's part, right? So these all phobias will be removed by the faculty member, and you have to make your own. Core competencies more enlarged, that you have to understand what my teachers are teaching and what you are. Please make a practice of coming into a mirror every day and start speaking with the mirror. Then you will understand what all mistakes you are making. See your expressions, how you're dealing with the things. So these are the many ways, many mantras when you can remove of your phobic issues, like for the exams and for the this meeting the people, interactions with the people, and a number of activities, right?
I actually did not expressed my this problem with my teachers till now. Like, it's been just 15 days, I guess, I've joined the classes.
See, you will understand. See, and mingling with the people is much, much more. Unless you have to understand. See, there's a market. Right now, institute is also a market, right? So, people management. understand, try to understand the people. In your classes, there might be 50 to 60 people who are studying, students who are studying. So yeah, mingle with all that. You need to understand each mindset. There will be agility. There will be a ambiguity every time in everyone, because what you are explaining, so the other might say, nahin yaar, isko aise kar lete, isko aise kar lete. So when you interact with people, you understand the agility of the people, what mindset he is saying, what minds he is saying. So these all things, confrontations, you will achieve, and you will understand, and then you will achieve. So now it's very low time, theek hai? It's high time to go, right? So all the faculty members will definitely help you out, but you have to make your own mantras for that.
Definitely. Thank you so much. I would definitely work
one
on
thing, and you were saying that you haven't expressed this things in front of your teachers. I think you should not hide anything from your teachers. Express them. They are here to teach you, Anna. So don't hide anything from your teachers. Just express them everything. What are you feeling? How are you comfortable with them? So how are you gonna be? I mean, you should not hide anything from your teachers. And as you're saying, you have 10 years of experience. You know, 10 years is a long time. It speaks. 10 years itself has a volume in it. Yeah, you have got the 10 years experience, and you're saying you get panic attacks, and okay, maybe saying it's a phobia since childhood. So I think you should record videos of yourself. Talk to yourself, just like Ashish said, talk to yourself in mirror. I think you should make videos of yourself, huh? And then watch those videos again. What are you talking about? How are you saying? How you're speaking? How are you interacting with yourself? You need to, I think, interact with yourself first, rather than interacting with your interviewer. I think you need to interact with yourself first. You need to know yourself first, I think. Look, I think 10 years experience is a volume itself, Vandana. You are lacking here.
Yes, I agree. That's why I joined this course at this point of time, because I was feeling so lack of confidence.
No. You shouldn't feel lack of. Why? There's a lack of confidence. See, you are here. It's 10 years experience, and you're saying you're working in a Lala company. I was with 2 years experience, and my confidence level was that. Even I know I am not able to speak properly in front of you here also. I know I cannot speak properly in front of all those faculty members. Manisha has spoken so well. Ashish is speaking so well. I know I cannot. Confidence level is here. Huh? You can say it's overconfidence. I don't know. You can say overconfidence. Okay, it's overconfidence. No. But I know I am confident. You just keep this in mind. You keep this in mind. You are confident. See, 10 years here, Vandana. What are you thinking about yourself? 10 years experience speaks. It itself is experience, 10 years, yeah? You shouldn't be feel less confident about yourself. Make videos, interact with yourself. And I think you just, I don't know, I'll speak to you personally sometime. You read something about law of attraction, I think. That helps me a lot. Meditate. Meditation will help you a lot. We'll speak later about that.
I'll definitely work on myself. Thank you so much for the suggestion.
I would like to say something, ma'am.
Yes, please. Yes, Vishali.
Thank you, ma'am. On behalf of the students, we would like to thank our dear alumni for educating that YMCA's office management course is our first step towards success. Your enriching experiences and words have inspired us today. We would also express our gratitude to General Secretary Sir and Director Ma'am for giving us an opportunity to interact with alumni. Thank you. Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you,
Vishali. In the interest of time, we would like to conclude this session. It was, in fact, a wonderful session. We feel honored and privileged to know from our own students, from our alumni, that not only how well-placed they are, but contented to the brim as well. So it makes our diploma worthy of doing by all those career aspirants who want to soar high in the sky. The only mantra to sail smoothly and successfully in life. Study hard as a student, and learn as much as you can to live it up your whole life. I'm assuring you that the red letter day will not be very far if you honestly work for it. In the end, I would like to thank our alumni who have spared their valuable time from their busy schedule, who answered so meticulously all the questions. I'm sure the tips given by you to your juniors will help them a long way in their lives and truly come up with flyers. I'm thankful to the GS and CEO of New Delhi YMCA, Mr. Marcus Clive, who has shared his valuable time with us. I'm thankful to Secretary Education, Mr. Vineet Masi, for being there to support us all the time. A very big thank you to Faculty of Office Management, working hard to make it successful, to make this session, and to make everything successful in the Institute. I thank all the students, attendees, and organizing team, technical team, for all that support at the back end. Thank one and all present here. Thank you so much.
I would like to add one point, ma'am. I would like to add one point. Right.
Please, Ashish.
See, many of the courses which are going on day-to-day basis in YMCA, right? But I would like to recommend if the three courses can be incorporated in YMCA, right? So, and which is a demand of the market right now. And it will definitely help YMCA in getting the companies for campus, and the big shot should be coming, right? Now, the first course which I'm speaking about is robotics, right? In a span of 15 to 20 years, India is coming, will be becoming a robotic. So many of the things would be done through robotic analysis. Second, the course is data analytics. So data analytics ke liye bhi bahut kaam chal raha hai. Abhi logo ko, abhi means we don't want people like with simple mindset with work Excel, PowerPoint presentation. Okay, data. How is their mindset? How sharp they can think? How is the data analytics part? The second course is data analytics. And third, and the most important, is artificial intelligence. Artificial intelligence is also playing a vital role in the market today. So if all these courses are coming on to YMCA and people are getting enrolled, and if more faculty members from all these industries are adopted in YMCA, definitely YMCA is going to make a much more heights in the market, right? And it will be a renowned one now. Yes. And many of the big shots will be coming for the campuses and taking the students. That's all. Thank you.
I would like to share that we have already started with AI, artificial intelligence, and
Hello.
Network issue.
Yeah, bully.
Hello.
I hope, ma'am, from your end, there is a certain issues going on.
With AI as well as data analyst program. So very soon we are going to start with robotics also. Thank you for sharing your views. Since we have 5 institutes with us, so one of the Institute for Management Studies, you know, it is already into this data analytics, digital marketing, artificial intelligence. So, and we are into blockchain also.
Okay,
so YMCA is with more than 100 programs right now. And almost 2,500 to 3,000 students with us.
Okay.
So this is just I wanted to share before leaving the session. So I'm thanking again one and all present. Thank you. Thanks a lot to our panelists.
Thank you so much.
In touch with your institute.
Sure.
Thank you. Yeah, definitely. Sure.
Thank you.